This is the fourth video for integration, where we're going to have a look at how we can use integration to find the area under a curve. If you're interested in the details of how we can use integration for working out the area under the curve, go and watch the year 13 integration video. I think it's the second one of the playlist where I talk about integration being the limit of a sum. But for year 12, you don't need to know it. There's a clue really in this diagram here and how this diagram turns into that diagram, but you don't really need to know the details for year 12. All you need to know is if you want to work out the area underneath this curve, you are going to do the definite integral of your function between the lower limit of a and the upper limit of b, like that, like we saw in the previous video of how to do definite integrals. If I want to find the area of a finite region between the curve with the equation y equals 20 minus x squared and the x-axis. First thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to draw a sketch of that so I can see what region I'm talking about. So, I want to factorise this. And if I factorise it, I think I will have a 5 and 4. I'm going to need to have a minus x and a plus x. I think that works. Yeah, so just factorising that. And I can see that it's going to have intercepts at minus 5 and at plus 4. So, in terms of sketching, I know it's going to go through at 4 and it's going to go through at minus 5. It's got a y-intercept of 20. So basically it's going to look something like that. And I want to find, I want to find this shaded area. The region that's bounded between the curve and the x-axis. So this is the region bounded by the curve and the x-axis. Okay, so to find that region, to find the area, all we need to do is we're going to integrate. Sorry, let me write that again, it's a mess. We're going to integrate y with respect to x between the limits of minus 5 and 4. So my y function is 20 minus x squared. And you saw how to do this in the previous video. So basically, that's going to integrate to be 20x. This is going to integrate to be x and a half x squared. This is going to integrate to be a third x cubed. We've got an upper limit of 4. We've got a lower limit of minus 5. We now set up two brackets, one for substituting in the 4, one for substituting in the minus 5, and we take the answers away. We've had lots of practice doing that, so I'm not going to bother doing the final steps of this question. The key things really is the sketch, so you can picture what's going on, and then finding out what the limits are going to be. Right, let's have a look at a slightly harder question. I want to. This question says to sketch the curve with this equation and to find the area of the finite region bounded by the curve and the x-axis. So, let's have a look at this curve. I know it's cubic. I know it's going to go through the origin. I know it's going to go through at plus 1 and at minus 3. And I know it'll be a positive x cubed, so it's going to start low and go up. So it's going to look something like that. So the area of the finite region bounded by the curve will be this region in here. Because that's the region that's between the curve and the x-axis, that is finite. Obviously, in this section down here, that's an infinite area down there. This is an infinite area over here. The only finite areas are these ones here. Now, the thing to be careful about is notice that this region here is above the x-axis, just like the previous example, which is fine. But this region here is below the x-axis. So if I were to integrate to find this region here, and you'll see this in a moment, that will give me a negative area. What that negative does, obviously there's no such thing as a negative area, but what the negative sign tells you is it's below the x-axis, which we can obviously see from my diagram. But it's important to draw the sketch so you realize that and can take that into consideration when you come to get your answer. So what we are going to do is we're going to do this in two stages. We're going to work out the area of the region between minus 3 and 0. We're then going to work out the area between 0 and 1. But we know that that's going to be a negative. So once we've worked that out, we'll make it positive to get an area that we can use. And then we'll add them together for the total. Okay, so let's do that. So let's call this region here, we'll call this region 1, and we'll call this region 2. So R1, R2. So R1 is equal to the integral from minus 3 to 0 of my function. Now I'm going to need to expand this out to be able to integrate it. So that's going to give me an x squared plus 2x minus 3. That's just expanding the two brackets, times that by another x. So that'll give me an x cubed plus 2x squared minus 3x. That's just expanding those three brackets. Okay. So let's have our square brackets. Right, raise the power, so that's going to be a power 4. Divide by 4. This is going to be a power 3. Divide by 3. And this is going to be a power 2. Divide by 2. So, introduce my curly set of brackets. This is for substituting the 0 in, this is for substituting the minus 3 in. Now actually, substituting the 0 in here, here and here will just give me 0. So I'm actually going to give myself a bit more room for the second set of brackets. Right, substitute the minus 3 in here. Be careful with these powers. So I'm going to keep the brackets there. Minus 3 cubed, minus 3 over 2, minus 3 squared. Okay, now obviously you could just type that into your calculator. Let me see if I can do it quickly then. So that's going to be minus 27, that's minus 54 over 3, that's 9, 7, minus 27. So I'm going to need a common denominator here. Should have just typed this into my calculator or had it done already, but it shouldn't take too long. I'm going to do the calculator now. So work this out. I really should have worked this out beforehand. Apologies for your sitting there watching me type numbers into my phone, but nearly done. Okay, so we get 0 minus 135 over 12. which obviously the double minus will make that a positive 135 degrees as well. So that is the area of R1. I've got a positive answer, which is what I expected, because I've got a positive, my region is above the x-axis. Now I'm going to work out R2, and I know I'm going to, well, I should get a negative answer for this. So R2 is the integral from 0 to 1, I think it was. 0 to 1, yes it is, of this function, my x cubed plus 2x. Now I've already done this integration above. My limits this time are 1 and 0. So two sets of brackets, one for substituting the 1 in, and then 1 for substituting the 0 in. I already know substituting 0 in will give me 0. So substituting the 1 in, that's going to be a quarter plus 2 thirds minus 3 over 2, which is 3 over 12 plus 8 over 12 minus 18 over 12, which is going to give me minus 7 over 12, no need for calculator there. And I've got a negative answer, which is what I expected. So my total area then is going to be R1 plus R2. R1 we worked out was 135 over 12. R2 was negative, but all that negative means is it's below the x-axis, so I don't really care about the negative at all. I'm going to add the positive. So I'm going to add 7 over 12. So my answer is 142 over 12, which I could simplify down some more, but I can't even bother to in this video because I think it's going on too long already. But that's it. The key thing, draw the sketch, so you can picture what's going on, so you can see which bit of the graph is above the x-axis, which bit is below the x-axis, so you can make sure that you get the correct signs at the end here when it comes to getting your final answer. Okay?